A new year means a new star-studded tour for the Harlem Globetrotters. It kicks off this week with games all across the country, but one of the first stops is right here in Memphis at FedEx Forum.
We're always so excited. The host, El Gato Melendez, is in his third season with the Harlem Globetrotters. Good to meet you.
Nice to meet you guys.
And even more excited, all three of us are excited
to
meet.
Yes, we are.
Kid reporter Xavier Stokes, how are you?
All right.
Good. You are looking hot today.
Yeah, you got your questions over there.
Yeah.
He's got the bow tie on. You're ready to go to work.
So first, why did you want to interview a Harlem Globetrotter, Xavier?
Well, I was recycling bottles, plastics, and stuff like that, and I started saving it.
Cool, because the Harlem Globetrotters are going green this year, right? That's a big deal.
Yes, yes. We are doing all kinds of approaches to, you know, teach and teach people how to do things the right way, recycle the right way, you know, take care of the planet. It's something that, you know, it's everybody's house, so we got to keep it clean.
That makes a lot of
That's
sense.
Awesome.
The Globetrotters themselves has always been a big part of your life, especially even in Puerto Rico. How did this all kind of start for you?
Well, the first time I saw them was on Scooby-Doo, so I was crazy about
Scooby-Doo.
I was crazy about it. I want to be Saturday morning. I want to go watch the Harlem Globetrotters messing around with Scooby and Shaggy. And then I was like around 6 years old, and I was all about basketball.
And yeah.
I'm in a country that, and you know, that's all baseball.
Yes,
like
yes.
You don't ask for a bat or a glove or a baseball ball in your tree, and you wake up on Christmas morning, it's there.
It's there.
It's there.
No doubt about it. It is right there.
It's there.
Santa Claus brought me some new stuff.
But you wanted a different ball.
I want to be a basketball player, and the part about it is that there's not that many basketball courts there. And it was far from my house, and that's how I got my nickname. Because I asked my dad, "Dad, I need a shortcut. This is taking forever." And he said, "Cut through the sugarcane field. We used to have a lot of those back in those days."
Right.
So I go after school. I got a ham sandwich. And I'm walking through, and some of the ham falls off. Next thing I know, it's like six cats falling. All that, I can make this up. So I go all the way out to the basketball court. The cats go all the way. And my friend's like, "Where did these cats come from?
Yeah.
What's going on?" Yeah, it's just one of me. So that's why I got my
And they led you to the court.
That's it.
So El Gato is cat in Puerto Rico.
Well,
I'm telling you what.
All right,
okay, Xavier, what do you want to ask?
We are ready to hear from you.
What do you
want to
ask
do you?
El Gato?
What do you do when you are not playing basketball or working?
That's a great
well,
question.
Well, when I'm not playing basketball and working, well, first of all, my job right now is not a job. It's a lifestyle. It's awesome. You have fun all the time while working. But I also interior designer when I'm not.
Wait a minute. Hold on.
Really?
Is this a true story?
It is a true story.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Interior designing.
Yeah. Actually, I did interior design for HGTV.
Seriously?
Wow.
That is so cool.
I did season 11 of Love It or List.
So cool.
Oh my God, that's one of my favorite shows.
All right.
With Hillary.
With Hillary.
Oh
all right. Baby. Because of Xavier, we're finding out even more. So, what else do you want to ask?
Where do you think you will be in the next 25 years?
Ooh,
that's
good.
A great question.
Yeah.
25 years is a long time, but I will say, you know, I want to be a Globetrotter as long as I can, as long as my body, because, you know, I like to, you know, share my stories with you guys and, like, people like you and, you know, try to educate as much as I can while I'm wearing a uniform and while not wearing a uniform. So eventually, you know, have a company bigger than what I have, interior design. And I'm also into music, so it's just different things. But it's hard to plan 25 years. But I was at 5 years, you know, keep doing what I'm doing.
But do you think you'll do the design thing after?
Yeah.
All right.
That's so awesome.
All right, Xavier, one last question. What else do you have?
What inspires you?
You, actually. Kids, family-oriented stuff. You know, I go to schools, I teach bullying prevention programs, I go visit hospitals. But for me, go every day and see smiles on people's faces is the best. So yeah, you're part of that inspiration, buddy.
That is
That's
awesome.
That's it. Great questions there for sure.
That was great.
Yeah.
So, Xavier, thank you for writing such a cool essay and winning this contest, because that's pretty cool.
Yes, ma'am.
Congratulations.
All right.
And we will get a chance to see the Harlem Globetrotters Saturday at FedEx Forum.
Yes.
right here in Memphis.
And I'm getting ready to start a reno project at my house. Can I get some tips behind the scenes?
That's going to take a lot of work.
Yeah.
I'll draw it out.
That's going to take a lot of work.
We can't talk about this.
That's going to be a long conversation.
I can't believe Love It or List It. I got to check that show out.
Good to see you guys. Thank you.